So for how long you are having these lipomas?
First I noticed it 10 years ago.
10 years ago.
Yeah, there was only one or two at the time.
Okay.
And then just gradually they all just started, the others just started showing.
Okay. So then when you noticed these swellings, what you did? You visited NHS?
So initially I visited my GP and he said it's harmless, you don't need to, it's just a cosmetic thing. We don't really remove it on the NHS, but you can do it privately. So I did actually get one removed in London a few years back.
Okay.
And it was a similar size to these ones here. It was this region here.
Okay.
So they
Almost the, they have taken the incision bigger than the size of this.
Yeah, similar size to it.
Okay.
Yeah. And it obviously left a mark.
Okay.
Because then I developed quite a few more.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't want to go through and have these cuts, you know.
So you were scared that there will be so many cuts if I remove all of them, especially on the arms, it will not look good.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Then what else you tried in this?
So after this, I was looking online to see if there's any method that can actually get rid of this fat without going through and cutting it and having stitches. And so I came across fat dissolving injections. And the one that I looked at in particular is called Aqualix. It was something that it's recently been FDA approved, but not for lipomas. It's been approved for like body fat, so like chin.
Yeah,
double
actually
chin.
These lipolytic injections are useful for double chin.
Uh-huh.
They can be useful for some irregular fats, or if there is some fats in your lavanders,
yeah,
or that area.
Yeah.
But not for this lipoma, because lipoma is a very well encapsulated thing.
Uh-huh.
Normally do not have that, it doesn't go like the way this fat goes.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you give the injection, it will induce a chemical reaction.
Yeah.
Though it may be lipolytic, but where that fat will go? It may become little soft, but rather than becoming soft, sometimes people are using different other injections also. And that what happens is they become very hard.
Yeah.
And thicker. What will happen in your case after the injection?
So when I got it done initially, actually it became inflamed.
Okay.
It got harder, but also it became darker initially.
It became darker.
So there's like a
because of inflammation, it will be pigmentation also.
Yeah. So then so the person that I visited, he said it's going to take a few injections to completely dissolve it. But he didn't. So after the first injection, he said let's wait for the pigmentation to go before we do it again. But because of the pigmentation, I got scared that, oh no, so if I inject it, and instead of scars, I'm going to have dark pigmentation everywhere, so I didn't go ahead with it. And it just got harder, you know, instead of being less movable like these ones.
It became harder.
It became hard as well.
Okay.
And that's when I came across your videos and then your recommendations of not having these injections done. Because, like you said, it's got a capsule,
yeah,
around it, and those injections will not get rid of that capsule. So it still stays, you know, and then you just, like you said, it's become fibrotic.
Yeah, it become inflamed, it become fibrotic, it become difficult for us to remove in future. And sometimes if it becomes thickened, it presses over the underneath structure.
Yeah.
It causes a stretching sensation. Maybe you get irregular tingling sensation or unusual sensation.
Uh-huh.
Even while removing these lipomas, we are very careful about the nerves around. Because that is a technical thing in this. And we have to nicely separate them. Even if they are sometimes very near to the blood vessels, we go around it and bring it up very nicely. Yeah. But lipolytic injections, I don't believe, especially in this. And you see, in one lipoma, when one lipolytic injection costed you how much?
It was about £400 or £500, I think.
£500 for one injection, and that was in which area?
It was
how many lipomas it was covering?
So this is for single lipoma.
Single
yeah. Lipoma.
£400 for single lipoma, you can understand the cost, how much cost it is going to be. Okay. So around minimum 5,000 plus Indian rupees.
Mm-hmm.
And if 400 you are talking.
So £400, and it was a single injection, and they told me that it won't go in one injection, it will take two or three maybe. But I just gave up after one because of the effects that I saw.
So you can understand the cost also, and ultimately no results.
Mm, exactly.
So, especially it is not recommended. Definitely it is recommended in double chin. I also recommend, sometimes I use for the double chin, those who are having the fat in unusual area, which looks like just a fat deposit. Definitely we can use that.
Mm.
So
So you say the best method is just to get it cut?
Yes, as at present we have, this is the available option.
Uh-huh.
Maybe in future if we get better, definitely we will be doing that. And in removing, what best technique we are trying, we are working on it. Until now what I have able to devise is this technique of microincision, which is helping very much to the patient. And I have people who are coming around the globe. We remove them, they come after 4 years, 5 years. Recently I had a guy from US, he came, removed these lipomas. 5 years back, again he came back for the rest of the lipomas. And you can imagine, he has this type of cluster. And what they did there, they had taken this big incision, thinking that we will go on this and go this, whatever is there, we will take out. But after that, he was so scared that he forgot about the surgery. Then suddenly, I don't know how he came across me. We removed his lipomas. He was very happy. He came back after 5 years.
Uh-huh.
And still, he has few lipomas, which we will remove after, whenever he comes next time.
Yeah. I mean, I came across you from YouTube, and that's the platform that I saw you on. And there's just no one that's doing it with this method, especially in the UK. They don't do it like that. They take the cut.
It's quite technically challenging.
Yeah.
It's not like that. Anyone just think about it and start doing it. It is like we have to be very, and experience matters a lot. Sometimes I have come across the people who have done this type of lipoma. They tried to do in their thing, but they did not take care of the nerves, and the patient had some issues with that. So I recommend, in proper guidance, it should be done by surgeons, not everyone around. Those who are trained or who understand this lipoma nicely.
Mm-hmm.
If you just treat and trial, like we do it, trial in the lipoma, put an injection, and then you come across the complications, it's not a good idea. So today we will be going for this, but definitely it was quite knowledgeable to know from you that this was my concept, and same thing happened for your case, that your lipoma has become very hard and it is very difficult to now remove, but we'll definitely remove. I have already removed lipomas for the persons who have done these many injections, but those injections were different than this one. Those also were not good for the patient, and they caused a lot of inflammatory reaction. In your case, there is pigmentation also, but in his case, it was fibrosis. Any other query?
No, I just want to say thank you, really, because honestly, it's just, this is a cosmetic issue, but it does affect people, you know, like mentally, you think.
I know, it's more of, sometimes it is a little bit, it causes psychologically, the person feels, what is this, why they are there, but many times it's a social reason.
Mm-hmm.
Recently, I am operated a girl who had so many people. You can see how her life was, like, she's an artist. And she has to work on the people around, and when she's working, so everybody notice her arms, this big swell.
Mm-hmm.
And they will be out, it will be a different life.
Yes.
For your case, they are not that big, but because it is concerning you, definitely we can remove. If they are not bothering, if they are not painful, sometimes we do not remove. I say don't remove. If those especially who are under this type of area, or those which are on the legs, they should be removed. Sometimes they are on the back and the abdomen. Sometimes we leave them also. If there are so many, then we have to choose which one to be removed.
Yeah. It's hard to explain to people what it is as well, because they look at the bump and they think, oh no, you've got,
yeah,
a tumor.
It's
difficult.
I had a person who had a lipoma, big lipoma in this area,
yeah.
And people were scared of it. If we touch him, that maybe it will come to us. But it is not the case. It is not a contagious disease.
Mm.
It is not a virus or something. It is just fat.
Yeah.
But you cannot explain everybody. To layman, it is, oh, I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
I will stay away from him. This happens.
Well, thank you. I really appreciate it.